everyone, Miss Katrina here.
And Miss Sam.
Welcome to Summer Streaming Series, a show where we watch the first episode of an old teen TV series and talk about it.
We will discuss the first episode, make predictions if we've never seen it, and tell you why you should or shouldn't watch it.
Everything we watch you can find online, so get ready to start your next binge watch. Katrina here.
And Miss Sam.
We're here today to talk to you about our show for this episode, Beverly Hills 90210. This show ran from 1990 to the year 2000, so it's a little bit of an old one, which you can kind of see in the show, which we'll discuss later. So Beverly Hills 90210 is a show about two twins, so a set of twins, a brother and a sister, who moved from Minneapolis, Minnesota, all the way to Beverly Hills. And it's all about them and their lives and their friends. So, me and Miss Sam watched the first episode and it is a two-parter.
Yes.
So we watched both parts because we felt like we could not just watch one. That would do a disservice to the podcast.
Yeah.
So let's start from the beginning. The first thing I noticed that I put a note of is the technology.
Oh my god, the cell phones?
The cassette player that the show starts off with, the alarm clocks. I think one person had a cell phone, or a car phone.
The car phone that had like the wire on it.
Rough. So that definitely dates the show. So if you have an issue with that, maybe don't watch it. But I can kind of look past it. Like
the other thing, I didn't realize it went to 2000. Like it's still 20 years old at this point, but I didn't think it ran until 2000.
I don't. Well, it ran for 10 years, which is a long time for like a teenage drama series.
Yeah, like I remember watching the like reboot or whatever that was on CW.
Yeah. I watched that one.
Where
too.
Like Kelly was still in it.
Yeah, she was.
Played, she played a teacher or something.
Uh-huh, she was. Definitely.
I watched that, because that was on when I was in, like, high school. I remember it.
Yeah, I remember, I think, episodes of that, which, again, were very similar, but also very different.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I don't think there were twins in that one at all.
They were siblings.
Okay, they were not twins.
Like, their brother was adopted or something?
I don't remember.
You can't even get it anywhere.
The new one?
No, it's not on anything.
Go figure. So the next thing I have noted was that when they first moved there, Brandon was like super popular in his old school,
yeah.
And Brenda was not at all popular. So I feel like that's like setting us up for this little like issue that's gonna happen
between the twins, the role reversal.
I also noticed that there's valet parking in the school.
Oh my god! I saw that. I was like, is that a valet for a school? Like, is that a thing?
I've never been to Beverly Hills. I have been to like Los Angeles and that area, but I feel like that is just a little ridiculous. I feel like they do not have valet parking. I think that was just kind of used to show how rich Beverly Hills really is.
Probably.
That's my guess. But if they did have valet parking, like more power to you, Beverly Hills. I would have been all about that in high school.
I hated parking in high school.
Also, I think like a really cool thing that they did when they first start is that Brandon is driving his car, which is like an old beat up brown car, which I think my boyfriend pointed out was a Chevy Chevette.
I don't even know what that is.
I don't, me either. He's a Subaru car, so he let me know. Everyone else had like very nice like red Ferraris, like Lamborghinis, very expensive cars, and they had this old used car, which kind of also points out the difference between
yeah.
like where they were growing up and where they are now.
Even like the way they were dressed, you could tell the difference. Mm-hmm. In the beginning, like they dressed more like
the parents definitely look different than like everyone else, like the teachers or everyone else in the school.
Yeah,
I noticed. But again, they were from Minnesota.
Yeah.
St. Paul, I think they said, or maybe
something like that.
I don't really know where anything is in Minnesota, so
sorry, Minnesota.
We also have a couple friends that they get introduced to. First we have Steve Sanders. So he used to date Kelly. He seems to be like a jock, and his mom is famous.
He looks too old to be in high school.
See, I had to Google him because I was like, this guy is definitely not 16. He's 26! listen, I'm all for like maybe 19, 20 paying a 16-year-old, but he could like have a family and a mortgage, and he looked it.
He did. He looked older than everybody.
He like, they definitely all looked, had a receding hairline.
They all looked older, but like he looked the oldest.
But he was not the oldest. The oldest is actually Andrea, who's kind of like the brain. She like takes a bus. We later find out that she lives far away and is like kind of lying to go to the good school. Mm. But Andrea is actually 29 in real life.
I feel like she looks so young.
I feel like she does not. I feel like she definitely looks like an adult. I totally disagree with you on that one. So Andrea Zuckerman, we just touched on. We also have Kelly, who the episode starts off with her talking about her new nose job, which, listen, I'm in love with Kelly.
I love Kelly.
She's the best. She dated Steve and now hates him and just like, is just so mean to him all the time. And I think it's great.
Kelly's my favorite.
And then our last person is David Silver, who is a freshman and kind of like a nerd, but he's a little bit younger, so I think it's kind of acceptable.
Yes.
So he's definitely going to worm his way into the group, I feel like.
And then there's Tori Spelling.
She's not really in the first episode. I mean, she kind of like, she plays Donna, so she kind of like is in the background, but later on in the season, she may take a more prominent role.
Okay.
But at the beginning, she's just kind of there.
I just remember that she's the producer's daughter.
Yeah, so she is the producer's daughter. That was the whole thing, like that's how she got on the show. And you can tell like she's just kind of quietly there. Also missing from the first episode is Dylan, who is my favorite. Dylan is kind of like the bad boy who I remember as a kid loving. So I remember the show, but I don't really remember plots.
I never watched the show ever.
But I remember the characters. Like I remember Dylan being like the cute bad boy. Let me tell you, I continue to watch the show, and he's still my favorite.
When does he come in?
He comes in like the third episode, I guess. Like okay. The pilot is kind of their test episode, so then like the second real episode, he kind of comes in. He's introduced like on his motorcycle, wearing a leather jacket, and immediately I was like, sold. So let's talk about the plot of the first episode. So Brandon meets a girl at a party, and it's her party.
Yeah, she's a rich girl who likes to hide.
She doesn't really have a lot of friends. I noticed that she writes her number on his arm in lipstick, which I feel like doesn't really make any sense. Because if he, like, just gets sweaty or rubs it, it's just going to rub away. And then he'll never know her phone number.
But he had it.
But she gave it to him. And he still did end up having it. So I guess that was successful. Steve gets really drunk and has to have David drive him home.
And he crashes his car.
And then David ends up crashing the car because he doesn't realize that it has to be in gear. I don't know how to drive stick shift, so I don't really know anything about that.
I know nothing about cars.
Brenda ends up getting into a club with a fake ID, and she meets an older man.
Can we talk about the license? How he was just able to, like, rip it?
Yeah, so apparently licenses, like, were not like they are now. Like, they were just paper.
I didn't know that.
Which, I mean, let's be honest, seems really easy to fake.
I know, like,
I guess that's why they've transitioned over, because if it's papers, I mean, but you have to remember, like, people didn't really have computers at home, so it wasn't like you could just print out a new one. Like, you couldn't scan it and print it out.
That's true.
Like, only the DMV, I guess, would have that sort of, like, nice printer computer setup.
Also, the printers and the...
Listen, I can't talk about it. Okay, so that's kind of the whole plot of episode one. Now we're gonna go to episode two. So Brandon is hanging out with the girl, the rich girl, and they're in a hot tub together, and he kind of like turns her down, which I feel like just sets up Brandon for being like a goody-goody, which I don't even like him already.
I don't mind Brandon.
Really? I feel like Brandon is a little like much of like a suck-up goody-goody, which again is kind of the change from the last when they first set them up.
Yeah, like he's trying to be a different person.
And Brenda's like going to a club meeting some 25-year-old lawyer who we now bring up, that lawyer Jason, who I've been calling him. He's 25 and she's 16.
Yes, and he also looks a lot older than 25.
He definitely does, and she does look 16. She lies and tells him that she's in college. And he ends up driving her home, and they end up kind of like dating. Also, at one point, lawyer Jason says she should get a phone, and she says she doesn't have one. And I was like, is it a cell phone? does cell phones even exist? Are they talking about a real phone?
Did cell phones exist in 1990?
I feel like they did, but not really. Like, there might have been those Nokia brick ones.
Like that brick one.
Or those giant Zach Morris phones that, like, were this big. Was he talking about a house phone?
I don't know.
I was really confused. Which I guess does not translate to technology now where we all have phones. I'm assuming he needs a house phone and she just lies and says she doesn't have a house phone. But did people not have house phones in the 90s?
I feel like that's impossible.
They must have.
Maybe he's talking about like a cell phone.
What else we got? Kelly's mom talks about her boyfriend Bob, who only sleeps. Who is this Bob? We never see him. I'm thinking he's like an old man, and Kelly's mom's like a gold digger who's just dating an old man to get a lot of money. That's my prediction.
I didn't even think of that.
Because why else would he just be sleeping over here unless he's like a loser?
I mean, I don't know. I didn't think of that.
Also in my notes is the science teacher is the guy from Jurassic Park. Yes. Who like jumps on the park, which is really, really creepy. I don't know.
I was trying to figure out where I knew him from.
Yeah, I had to look him up, and I was like, I think that's the dude from Jurassic Park, and he is.
Is he also in Billy Madison?
He is in Billy Madison. He's the creepy principal, who's like the professional wrestler. Brandon gets flowers delivered to school in his classroom by the rich girl, and then he kind of leads his friends to believe that something happened between them.
And then she got upset with him.
And then she does get upset with him, and they kind of like break up because of the whole situation. The whole flowers delivered to school, like, I would be super embarrassed.
I didn't think that was a thing. Like, that someone could just go into the school with flowers and walk around, finding some kid in their classroom.
Yeah, like, maybe that's a Beverly Hills thing. Well, the rich girl does end up punching Brandon.
Yes.
You go, girl. I would do the same thing. David leaves his friend. Oh, so David, back to David. He crashed the car, but David, Steve doesn't really know it's David, and they end up leaving his friend's hat in the car.
Yes.
So they have to go back to get it because they don't want David to know. And then Steve apparently has a car alarm that's linked to his beeper that goes off.
Is that what that was?
Yeah, I think it was like a car alarm beeper alert service, which I feel like they definitely did not have that technology in the 90s. They were definitely making
that. I was trying to figure out what that was. Yeah,
it's his beeper. You didn't know it was a beeper?
No.
My brother had a beeper. That's the only reason why I know.
No, like no one had a beeper that I mean, my parents did.
I feel like beepers were more like teenagers had them.
Were they like, what is a beeper?
It's like a little thing, like maybe like half the size of your cell phone. And you could call a number. So you had like a beeper number. So you call the number and then you would leave a number in. So there used to be all these like beeper codes. So I don't know if you guys even know about like 143. That was like kind of like that was like a little code. It means like, I love you in like beeper language. So there was all these like beeper codes that you would use. So like, because it can only send numbers, it wasn't pictures or anything. You would just like call the phone number, type in a number and then hit like pound or something. And then it would send it to the beeper. So I would beep Sam and be like, 143. And then she'd look at it and be like, oh, Katrina loves me. And that was kind of it. Or like you could like beep your kid, like call me now. But you would just like beep the phone number and then you would call back the phone.
Oh, okay. Now
so,
I understand.
So I'm sure he had some sort of beeper code for his car alarm going on.
Like a low jack?
Yeah, that's like GPS or something. They didn't have GPS. We are before GPS, guys. This is like an ancient show.
This show is as old as I am.
Yeah, pretty much. Okay, let's get back to the show. Enough about beepers. Where are we at? Oh, hat card. Okay, so Brenda goes on the date with old lawyer Jason and his friends. And she seems very uncomfortable, which as a 16-year-old hanging out with 25-year-olds, I would probably be too.
She pretends she's studying astronomy.
Yeah, I think astronomy. And then they ask her questions and she doesn't know anything about it. Like, why not pick something you know? Like, I'm studying high schoolers.
Yeah.
Would have been a better answer, Brenda.
I'm becoming a teacher.
Yeah, she's supposed to be smart. Guess not. Brandon goes on the radio and tells everyone that he did not sleep with Marianne Moore. Which I thought was like super dramatic. Like, you didn't have to go on the radio all over school to tell them that. You could have just like told people you lied.
I mean, yeah. But they do have a radio station, so I guess that's the best way to get the message across.
I guess you reach like more people that way. Brenda finds out that she's getting a D minus in science because she's too busy clubbing and going out with her old boyfriend.
That escalated quite quickly because I feel like they've only been in school for like a week.
Yeah, and she's already getting a D minus in science. Like, what teacher has those grades already? Maybe she had like one test and it was a D minus?
They had that pop quiz.
So maybe the pop quiz is a D minus? Brandon follows Andrea on the bus and finds out that she does not live in Beverly Hills, which we kind of touched about. So her and her family are lying so she can be in a good school, which I don't really blame her.
No, I would want to go to the good school.
Me too. Jason says he got a couch with his ex and didn't like it because it would be around longer than her, and then they broke up. Excuse me?
And he wasn't that great of a guy.
No, he was terrible. So he says that he bought a couch and he only bought the couch he liked, not the couch she liked, even though they lived together, because the couch would be around longer than her.
He was not a nice person.
Like, that is a red flag if I've ever heard one. Dump old boy or Jason, Brenda. Then Brenda tells Jason that she's 16, but in like a public setting, in like a restaurant.
It's the best place to do it, because if he flips out, he's gonna arrest.
Which he did, and he said that he's gonna sue her parents.
Which you can't do because she's underage.
And he's a lawyer! He should know that you can't just sue someone's parents because they say they're 16.
But if you tell a 16-year-old, I'm gonna sue your parents, she's gonna be like, oh my god.
Because she doesn't really know, I guess. Which makes him even more of a scumbag when you think about it. He's like kind of manipulating her double. Okay, so that's all the notes I have for the episode. We are going to do our predictions because, again, as much as I saw it as like a little kid, I really don't remember anything.
I can go first.
Okay. So my first prediction is that Beverly Hills is going to eat these Minnesota people alive. They are going to be destroyed. They're not used to Beverly Hills. They're not used to all these rich, mean girls and rich, mean people. Everyone's kind of terrible. I did watch like the first season or most of the first season, and most people are terrible there, so I feel like they're gonna be eaten alive.
I can see that. I only watched the first two episodes. I feel like lawyer Jason, mean person, is gonna come back. Okay. I don't know if that's true. I feel like she's gonna go back to him. I don't know.
So in the first season, that does not happen, I can tell you.
Oh, okay. I was wrong. My prediction's wrong. I know nothing.
That's the only thing I know. My second prediction is that Brandon's gonna get with Kelly, yes, and Andrea will be involved in this sort of love triangle.
I feel like Andrea's gonna like Jason, but he's not gonna return the favor.
Brandon?
Yeah, Brandon.
Yeah, not old boy Jason.
Not Jason. Sorry, Brandon. Mixing up all these names. Brandon is not gonna return her feelings. He's just gonna see her as a friend.
And he's gonna get with Kelly.
I feel like he's gonna end up with Kelly. But I don't know. I haven't gone past the second episode, so I don't know any new characters.
We're supposed to be basing this on the first two episodes, yeah. So it's fine.
That's my prediction.
David and Steve are gonna become BFFs.
Yes. He's gonna be like the little sidekick.
Yeah.
He's gonna adopt the freshman.
Yeah, I agree. I think that's gotta happen. And my other prediction is that Brenda has like 65 boyfriends throughout the whole series. So she's gonna dump lawyer Jason, never hear from him again, and like every episode, she's gonna have a new boyfriend.
I don't really like her.
You don't like Brenda?
No.
I have a friend who sent me a picture of Brenda, of the actress, Shannon Doherty, and told me that her eyes are uneven, and now I can't unsee it.
I didn't notice.
And so you're gonna notice it. If you watch it, look at her uneven eyes. Because now I can never like take that back. It's like Megan Fox and her like toe thumbs.
Oh my god.
Like you can never not notice them.
Now you ruined it.
I'm sorry. I mean, I like her as an actress.
I think she's a really good actress. I just don't like the character
of Brenda.
Yeah.
I feel like she just is trying really hard to get everyone to like her, which again makes sense based off of like she wasn't really popular at her old school and she's trying to fit in. She's 16, like I kind of get it.
Maybe I'll like her more as the season goes on, but like right now she's not my favorite.
I kind of like her more. Like I watched, like I said, most of the first season. I do like her more. Brandon, though, I could take him or leave him.
I have to see what happens. You've seen more than I have.
Yeah. Well, we're supposed to base this on the first episode.
Yeah.
Okay, so now we're going to tell you if you should or should not watch 90210. Sam?
I am going to continue watching it because I want to see where this goes. And I feel like it's such a like a iconic show that everyone has seen. And I just have never watched it. I mean, I was little when it came out. So like, I was a baby. So like I've never obviously seen it.
You
so
feel like you should watch it.
I feel like I need to watch it just like as a rite of passage, I guess, to watch the show that everyone has always talked about and still talked about today.
It's true. It is.
And they brought it back like 9 times. Like
also true.
Also they rebooted it a bunch. So obviously like it resonates with people. So I think I'm going to continue watching it and see how it goes the first season. And then maybe continue watching the other 10 or whatever there are.
There's a bunch of things.
There's a lot. So I'm going to say I'm going to watch it. But if you don't like old 90s, does not interest you, then you probably would not want to watch the show.
If you can't get past the technology.
And the outfits.
Well, hold on. We got to take a side to talk about these outfits. We'll get back to if I think you should watch it or not. The outfits I think are great. I love it. Everyone is dressed like super fashionable. I had to text one of my friends who was a little bit older and ask like, is this how people dress in the 90s? And it sort of was. Which like everyone's just wearing a blazer all the time.
And like jean shorts with like long leggings underneath them.
Yeah, that's also like the like very layered, a lot of blazers. A lot of like very solid bright
shoulder
colors.
Pads.
There's like no outfits with stuff written on them, which is very like 2000s, I guess. Like that was before that. But yes. Like now we have all these design stuff. Everything is just like a solid red shirt,
yep.
A solid blue shirt, which I kind of enjoyed that.
Yes, it was different.
That was like a plus for me. Okay, so I am going to tell you if I think you should watch it. I'm going to say yes. You should definitely watch 90210. I started the first two episodes and then we kind of continued. I even got my boyfriend roped into it to the point where he requests to watch it. So, it's really great. There's a lot of really crazy stories.
Is it like almost like a soap opera?
It's very like soap opera-ish. Like every episode is different. Like there's like a main problem in every episode and then you kind of follow the rest of the storyline. Like very like Law and Order, like where there's like one case you gotta solve and then like everything else like follows through.
Okay.
So I would definitely recommend it. I think it does translate over. Everything is very similar. They all it's very like I would say controversial for the 90s. Like I would have thought in the 90s everything would have been like very like everything's perfect, everything's great, happy ending. And it's really not. There are definitely some real problems and some real situations going on. So I say yes, watch 90210.
Hey everyone, we're back. I want to let you know that next week, tune in because we're going to be watching Dawson's Creek.
I'm so excited to watch Dawson's Creek.
My dogs want to let you know that we're watching Dawson's Creek and they're super pumped.
Listen to them.